All right, today I'm just cutting out fabric because I'm going to tea stain it first for my stocking. You can see my stocking form right here. So I'm just cutting out my fabric right now, and then I'm going to plan on staining that in some tea. And that's the fabric I've already cut. Now I'm tracing the stocking on the leftover tablecloth, old tablecloth that I used. Okay, now let's cut out the stockings. Last cut. Okay, as you can see, this is the transfer. This is on in reverse. And you do this on transfer paper. It's white. It's better to use white for lighter fabrics. They sell a black one for dark fabrics. So now what I'm going to do is turn this over. I heat this lightly first just to get it warm. And then I position this the way I want it. And then I take the iron, and you have to use two hands, the instructions say that, and you have to push, but not go back and forth like when you're ironing a pair of pants. You want to go back and forth, but you have to push and apply the pressure firmly. And really, I usually count to like 50-50, and then it's usually ready to peel off. Another thing I want to mention is you cannot use an ironing board at all. It's too soft. You have to use a piece of plywood or another kind of piece of wood or an absolutely smooth tile. It has to be smooth. It cannot be bumpy at all. So wood is really the best bet and the way to go because I have done this before. Okay, now I'm pulling the paper off the transfer after I ironed it. Here we go. All done. Look how beautiful that looks. Okay, so now let's cut out a little bit of pieces from another transfer. I'm using pinking shears. And I'm going to cut these little pieces, and I'm going to put some on the heel and the toe to make them look like patches. They all have to be perfect. Now I'm holding the iron on again firmly. You don't have to put tons of pressure, just enough pressure on here for about 30 seconds to make a patch on the back heel. Okay, now I'm peeling it off the heel. And perfect. Okay, now I'm peeling this off. I just ironed it on to look like another patch. This is a very easy process. By all means, don't be intimidated by this. It's very, very easy. All right, now I'm going to apply glue to the edges. And if you notice, the image is on the inside. I'm doing this because as I glue it, the image has to be on the inside so I could flip it inside, the right side out. And the image will be there. Okay, as you can see, the glue I did all the way around the base and on the edge. Don't go too close to the edge because you don't want it to ooze out. Okay, I just wanted to let you know that I have seen this project done online with hot glue. That will work perfectly fine. And if you're comfortable with that, do it by all means. I decided not to do that and use fabric glue. One, this dries quickly, and two, this will allow me to machine wash these on cold water. If you use hot glue, you can never wash them. And that was the reason why I chose this specific fabric glue. Okay, so now you can see I turned this one stocking in the right direction. This piece here is this piece. I had this left over that I kept from old stocking tops that I ordered years ago. And I stuck this part inside, and I'll show you, and I added glue here, and then I glued it to the inside of the stocking when the stocking was flipped in the right direction. So as you could see, I put the other topper in here, and it's inside the stocking. Now I'm just going to add some of the fabric glue. Go straight across. And then I'm going to pull this up a little bit so it lays flat under that ruffle. Now it just has to dry. Okay, so for the other two stockings, because I only had two of those toppers that I saved, this part is from a ruffle is from a runner that I didn't use anymore, so I cut it off and I saved it. So now what I'm going to do is I'm folding it. See, it's folded halfway. And then I'm going to fold it this way. I'm folding it to here. And then I'm going to glue it so it makes a ruffle for my other stockings. Here's one I already glued. Now I'm going to add the glue to this. Fold this over. Okay, so now I'm going to glue. Put glue on this ruffle. I'm standing behind the glue, so it's hard to see if the glue's coming out. There we go. I'm gonna push this down lightly and let that dry. Okay, so I'm going to get ready to glue this last one. Now remember, also I wanted to mention, I made this for really no cost. The stockings are made from a leftover tablecloth that unfortunately shrank. All of these stocking toppers are from leftover pieces of fabric. So don't always think I have to spend a lot of money to make these things. You don't. Save what you have a lot of times, and you may not realize that you can make something out of it. But this is what happens, and I made four brand new stockings that look very expensive for no cost. These are my finished stockings. I am so excited with how they turned out. They look vintage, they look classy, they look elegant. I would love for you to come to closuresandlavender.com and visit my blog and sign up to follow. And also sign up to follow my YouTube channel.